Hello and welcome back. Today we're going to create a hands-free IR-activated voice recorder with a motion-activated playback. We're going to do this using the ISD1820 module. Today's video comes as a response to a question that I received on a video. Wendy says, does the button always have to be pressed with the ISD1820? I want to make something where I can record a message on the board and into the mic, and then when the motion goes off, the recording sets off. All without pressing the button. Can this be done? In fact, it can be done. There is a pin on that board, and you can use a number of sensors or other components to replace that button, whatever you want to use. Today we're going to use an IR sensor because it's hands-free. So let's get to it. So for this project, every time I swipe my hand near this motion sensor, it'll set off that recording right there. And I put that little squeak at the end just so it's easier to hear. This is kind of hard to hear, the speaker, and I have it sitting on a cap from a bottle just to amplify the sound a little bit more. And I'll talk about that here at the very end, how to make it louder. But as you can see, here's the ISD1820 board. After you solder the wires on the speaker, you can plug the speaker in right there, the white part there. As you can see, I'm just using four pins on this board, the play E pin, the record pin, the ground, and VCC pins. Over here, I have the IR pin. That's just a VCC, a ground, and an out pin, or a data pin. A data pin is connected to pin 4 of the Arduino Mega there. And whenever I brush my hand in front of that, it will record. And I have to keep my hand in front of it to continue to record. Over here, we have the motion sensor. I have it propped up here with some Raspberry Pi. But every time I swipe my hand in front of that, it sets off the recording, and it works nicely. So this is the speaker, and if you have it laying on a flat surface, it's kind of hard to hear. So elevate it a little bit, and you can also use an amplifier to make it louder. Here's an option to amplify your speaker. This is the LM386 Mono Audio Amplifier module, and this is perfect because it operates on 5 volt to 12 volt. It also has a 10K adjustable potentiometer to turn your volume up and down. Now, I personally don't have one of these, but I do play around with these speakers enough to where this may come in handy for me. Now here's my diagram. I'm going to call it my spaghetti diagram because it looks like there's a lot going on, but there's really not. I just have four data pins being used, and everything else is just connected to 5 volt and ground because each one of these items can operate off of 5 volts. In the code, I did define all four of the data pins that we're using, and then down in the setup, I set up the record and play buttons as outputs, the motion sensor pin as an input, and the IR data pin as an input with a pull-up resistor. As you can see in the loop, we're continually monitoring our IR pin and our motion pin state, and when the IR pin is high or active, it'll go into record mode, and then if the motion sensor is active, it'll go into playback mode. If both of those pins aren't active, both of those pins remain low and nothing happens. This code may be short enough to share in the description below, but if not, it'll definitely be posted to our Facebook page, and you're welcome to check it out and use it. Now here's a top view, and I'm using my hand to activate the IR voice recording. And you see, you have to keep your hand in front of it to continually record. The moment you take your hand away, it's going to stop recording.
Hello, hello!
And I add that little squeak there so you can hear it better. If you decide to mount this project to a board or something, you may want to point that IR sensor away so it's not accidentally activated. And I chose the IR sensor because it has a fairly small activation range, which should cut down on any accidental triggers. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoy projects like this, I hope you consider subscribing to the channel, like the video, and I'll see you again very soon. Thanks.